Good morning. We want to welcome you to our Nature Nugget this Sabbath morning. And Brother Ron Toel has come to share with us some insights on frogs, bugs, and sloths. And so I'm going to pass the mic over to him. And we have some pictures to go with it. And if you're listening in the internet, on the internet, you can download these slides from smyrna.org under the link for Sabbath School. And Brother Ron, if you'd like to come here.
Good morning and happy Sabbath. The first little story or nugget is about a little green tree frog lives in the rainforest. And, of course, it lives up in the trees and eats bugs and stuff on that order. But when she mates, she usually lays 6 to 8 eggs. They are fertilized, and then she picks them up in her mouth and swallows them. And these eggs hatch in her stomach. She does not eat for 8 weeks, and the tadpoles metamorphize into little green frogs. And at the end of 8 to 9 weeks, she doesn't eat during this whole time. She regurgitates them and puts them out on the forest floor and then leaves. Well, my question is, who teaches them to eat bugs? Because they don't even know what a bug is. And, you know, isn't this an amazing thing that
That's
God
right.
can do?
And the next one is this creature.
It's called the peanut-nosed bug. It, as you can see from the picture, its head is shaped kind of like a peanut shell. And its eye is way back behind this peanut shell, so it's got this big, long proboscis nose, whatever you want to call it, sticking out front. Well, what is unusual about this bug, and you can see also that he blends in with his background and stuff, but when this bug, a little monkey, comes up to him, he also lives in the rainforest, but a little monkey comes up to him and tries to grab him to eat him or something like that, he puts his nose on the tree and he starts to vibrate. And it resonates very loudly. That's why his nose is hollow, and it's like the nose of an elephant seal. You know, when they beller, it resonates it. This bug then throws its wings out, and when it does that, it also throws out a mist of brown dust. And this brown dust that it throws out has a very skunk-like smell. The brown dust is just very, very pungent odor. And, you know, you look at this insect, and nobody likes bugs, but this one, when he protects himself, he appeals to all the senses. The sense of sound, the sense of sight with his wings, and the sense of smell with the stench. Again, I say, isn't that amazing? And now we're going to go to the sloth. Everybody knows what a sloth is. It's this little furry animal that lives in the rainforest and looks like it fell out of a tree and landed on its nose and pushed its face into the ground, you know, and flattened his face. But he spends 90% of his time upside down. He's got these big long claws that he can grasp onto the branches of the trees and stuff. And the only time he is upright is when he crawls down a tree and moves over to a different tree. Now, something you all know, but never thought of probably, because he hangs upside down, his hair grows up instead of down. And he lives in the rainforest, as I said. He gets rained on 4 or 5 times a day. Now, wouldn't you expect to see kind of a green sloth because of all the algae and lichens and stuff that might be growing in his hair? But you've never seen a picture of one of these. You know why? Because God also created a little insect that lives in his fur. that eats the algae and stuff off of his fur to keep it from getting matted. Mm-hmm. Now, that in itself to me is amazing. And if you want a bunch more of these amazing type stories, come to camp meeting.
That's right.
And that's all I have for you this morning. Thank you.